Hello everyone, my name is Sristen Dias and you are at Basic Marine Engineering. So today we'll be talking about starting airline explosion. So whenever we speak about starting airline explosion, it is an explosion caused due to starting airline, of the starting airline. And normally whenever we want some, you know, we all know about the fire triangle. The fire triangle requires three things: air, fuel and some ignition. So what happens is, the source of heat, ignition, which is going to be supplied, is going to be your cylinder pressure. Now what happens, to understand how the starting airline explodes, we have to understand that how a compressor is running. How a compressor is running, it's producing that air pressure and supplying to your air bottle. Now when the piston inside is moving, the parts inside is moving, it requires some kind of cylinder lubrication. Now for that cylinder lubrication, what we do is we supply lube oil. Now that lube oil, some of it will get carried over. We will be draining in air bottle, we will be doing drains other places, even your starting airline has drain, but still some of it gets carried away with your air to your starting air manifold. Now from your starting air manifold, we have one line going to each unit, to each cylinder head. Now what happens is, suppose if your starting air valve, which is there on your each unit, gets stuck or it starts leaking, then what will happen is, whatever the unit which is firing, that heat is coming inside. Now once this heat comes inside, the fuel, the burning material which is there, that is lube oil, which is already present, and your air supply comes, that time you will have a starting airline explosion. Now to prevent that, what kind of safeties do we have? First of all, we have something called as relief valve. Now relief valve might not be there on each and every engine, but if you have it, you will be having it common. If you don't have relief valve, you always have bursting disc. Now bursting disc is a disc provided. Basically the idea is, whenever the pressure will rise, it will just burst. So it will prevent any further movement of, you know, explosion taking place. Then we also have something called as non-return valve. Basically non-return valve is provided on your, just after your air bottle, just before your main air starting valve, you know. Now that non-return valve is provided so that that entire fire or that explosion doesn't take, you know, move on to your air bottle, because then you have to imagine, in your air bottle there will be more amount of, you know, oil present, more amount of air is present plus a pressure vessel exploding is a huge explosion. Then we also have something called as flame arrester. Now flame arrester is just before the, once the, you know, the air is going to the engine, to the starting air valve, just after the starting air valve you can see. So that just before, you know, between the manifold and your starting air valve, you will have this flame arrester. What this flame arrester will do, it will prevent any kind of flame which is coming, it will arrest it. So that your fire doesn't go here, your heat source doesn't go here, and your triangle is not completed. Now, then what you have to do is, the few ways in which you can, you know, prevent starting airline explosion. One, you keep draining your tanks, your air bottles. Keep draining, every watch we drain, plus during maneuvering we drain, plus before maneuvering or before preparation of the engine or before we come to port, when we are running, when we are topping up the air bottle, we drain more frequently. So that, you know, if extra oil whichever is produced is been removed, we have to maintain our compressors in proper order. We have to maintain them well. We have to, you know, so that the oil carryover doesn't take place, we have to ensure that. Then we have, you know, starting air valve overhauling, so that the starting air valve is not sticking. We try to maintain that frequently. Then we also have starting airline drain. So normally if you go in any checklist, you'll find that starting airline also has to be drained before you open the valve to drain the starting airline, so that any oil if you present, it can be drained. So these are the few things which you have to take care whenever it comes to starting airline, so that you don't have accidents and you don't cause any kind of starting airline explosion. So I hope you guys have understood. If I have missed out anything, you can still write down, comment below. And till my next video, best of luck, be safe, bye bye.